Sometimes getting out the door for your run is literally the hardest part of it. We've all been through moments, days, weeks, even months of feeling completely unmotivated, and let's admit it, it sucks when that happens. That said, today I'm going to talk about 10 ways to boost your running and workout motivation. A lack of motivation can be short-term, whether it's just one day when you're feeling off, but it also can be long-term as well. And in my opinion, when it's more long-term, there's usually a deeper root that needs to be addressed to it. So that being said, I hope today I'm able to cover kind of both of those when I talk about the methods that I use to help myself when I'm feeling unmotivated. Starting with number one, get changed. So many times when I'm just laying around and I'm feeling kind of gross, the simple act of putting on my workout clothes can make all the difference. It kind of just like switches your mind to like workout mode, similar to dress to impress or dressing up on the day of a test or an exam. Kind of putting your workout clothes just switches your mindset, makes you confident, and it's also just another step that gets you further to getting out the door. Number two, music. I think music is one we can pretty much all agree on. In my opinion, it's like the most universal pump-up method throughout sports. And you're gonna wanna find music that works best for you and gets you into the best headspace and mindset. So for me, sometimes I'm really nervous, so in order to calm myself down, I have to listen to like Jack Johnson or John Mayer or Jason Mraz, something nice and soothing and happy. But then other times I'm ready to go, I wanna get amped, so I'll throw on some Fergie or something like that to jam out to before my run. Number three is to change up your running route. I personally think it's really easy to kind of defaultly run the same route every single day, especially if you've been living in the same place. You know, it's convenient, you know you won't get lost, you know the mile markers of your favorite route, and that's cool, but sometimes it can get really mundane and really boring. So I think having a run or two here and there, especially when you're feeling unmotivated, to kind of just run wherever your heart wants to run and kind of just maybe either follow the direction of the light or turn down a road you've literally never turned down before, even though you've been living at the same place for 10 years. You can also try to find a new trail, whether it's gravel or grass, maybe some fields at your local high school. That way too, you're killing two birds with one stone. One, you're spicing up your run, and two, you're also getting on some soft surfaces to protect your legs. Number four, meet up with a friend. So if you're someone like me, I'm not a part of a run club or a team anymore, so I run alone literally every day. But I do have some old high school teammates that live within driving range, and I just think having those days where you can meet up with a friend is huge for accountability. It can be fun, you guys can catch up, you know, and enjoy the company, and you kind of find that spark again. You can kind of go back to the roots of running and realize that the running community is such a big part of our sport and can be so motivating. If you do have an opportunity to join a run club or a team where you live, I highly recommend checking one out and finding one that fits best for you. I just think there's so much value in having a team and having training partners, and I miss it literally every day. All right, so the next thing you can do to help you get motivated is to plan a fun post-workout meal or snack. I want to make it clear that this is not a message to surround your workout around food or have food as the reward. It is simply just a suggestion to add some strategic joy to your workout. So whether you're running 1 mile or running 10 miles, I think it's so much fun to have, you know, a fun snack or a fun meal to look forward to afterwards. So for example, after long runs, I love to have like a big brunch or something like that, whether that's pancakes, something like that, or muffins, or maybe my post-workout smoothie even gets me going and gets me through those last few miles when I might be struggling. Number six, have a plan. So I do think it can be beneficial to have a rough plan of what you're going to be doing that day in terms of your run or your workout. I find that for me, whenever I'm feeling the most unmotivated is always when I literally am going to the gym and have no idea what I'm gonna do. Now I do think there is a time and place for those unplanned workouts to kind of work out intuitively, but if you're struggling with some motivation, I think having some structure can be key. Number seven, invest in a coach. So kind of going off that last point, having a coach has made all the difference, at least for me. It is just so awesome to have, you know, that next level of expertise guiding you along some training, and it's great to hold you accountable as well. I know that for me, if I were training myself and writing myself a training plan, I would always have some kind of some questions and some unknowns. And also, I don't think I would really be running to my fullest potential. The next thing you can do if you're feeling unmotivated is simple. Take a break. Mental burnout is a real thing, and it's all about kind of learning yourself and what your limits are. So if you're feeling unmotivated for a very long time, maybe it's time to either take a rest day if you haven't had one in a while, or maybe it's time to take that downtime. And like I was saying in my downtime video, taking a break from running can really stir up the enthusiasm that you might need to get back out the door and get back to training. Number 9, sign up for a race. Now, I know at this uncertain time, there's a lot of lingering fear and anxiety, kind of wondering whether or not your race will be canceled or postponed. So despite all the cancellations and the postponements, and despite, you know, the risk of your race being canceled in the future too, I still think there is a lot of value in training for it. You know, you can have that training cycle, have that training block, and even if your race ends up getting canceled, none of that training goes to waste. I firmly believe that, and you know, if it ends up being canceled, you're still gonna have all the work to put into your base and to put into your running strength for future races moving forward into the following years. Fortunately too, there are some virtual races that you can do. That's not my personal preference, but I know a lot of people have been thriving off them and doing time trials kind of by themselves. So just setting a date and having something to work towards that's really tangible, whether it's a time trial, virtual race, or actual race, is very, very valuable because you can set goals that can then serve as motivation for you to get out the door every day. The last way I'm going to talk about is to start small. Sometimes a run or a workout can kind of feel really intimidating depending on how long or how hard it's going to be. I personally kind of deal with that a lot. And for me, I just start small. So I'll just tell myself to go out and run just a mile or just 10 minutes. By telling myself that, I really kind of calm the anxiety and the intimidation of the longer run or the big, you know, bulk of the workout. And then when I go outside and I end up running that mile, most often I feel good enough and I kind of get into my groove that I can keep going. You can also even make it simpler than that. Maybe you go outside and just tell yourself, you know, to run to that next mailbox and then make it to the stop sign. Maybe make it 2 more minutes or, you know, count your steps, count to 50 and see if you can get to 50 steps. Just little things like that to break up the workout can help so much mentally, especially for me. And before I know it, after moments and moments of going, okay, 1 mile at a time, or get to the lamppost, before I know it, I'm done my run. Sometimes all you need is that little momentum to get the ball rolling. Before I close out this video, I do want to say that it is so important to allow yourself some grace. So just remember that when you're feeling unmotivated, that all athletes go through that, whether it's one run, one day, or even a longer period of time, like weeks or months. All athletes go through it and there are ways to get out of it, but I do think you should be kind to yourself, kind of just listen to your heart, listen to your body, and listen to your gut. Remember, at the end of the day, you need to find something that makes you happy and find a training plan that is sustainable for you and that you enjoy. All right, so if you made it this far, I just wanna say thank you so much. Thank you for watching. I hope you found it helpful. And if you have any other tips that help you when you're feeling unmotivated, feel free to leave them in the comments below. Thank you for watching. I would love for you to like this video and subscribe to my channel. I hope you enjoyed it, and until next week, happy running.